stop that? You know, I don't know that I can top it. Honestly, sometimes I preach sermons and I think, I'll say to Cindy or Taylor, you know, I don't know, that's just... And then somebody in the congregation will come up to me and say, I just want you to know that, oh, I needed to hear that today. And I just want to say, what did you hear? But I'll tell you, I heard something when you were singing there. Thank you for... you know what I love about you in the short time that we have got to know each other is that it's not just, you're not just singing words. So, I appreciate it. All right, you ready? Picture yourself riding the SEPTA train. It's a big switch from what we just heard. Picture yourself riding the SEPTA train at rush hour, or even better, on the way to an Eagles playoff. Now imagine the noise of the crowd, the loud talk. Some people have already had a few, so they're louder than the other ones. The pushing and the shoving as people are standing in the aisles of the train. It's already crowded. There are no seats available, and people are still coming on board. Okay, so you make it to the station, and your personal space has been invaded and conquered, right, by the crowd. You introverts are needing to get out and walk and not be touched by anyone. Which is all well and good until you get to the stadium. And you're right back to where you were, people everywhere as you go through that bottleneck at the entrance. By this point in your day, you've been pushed and you've been shoved. Do you know that feeling? Can I hear an amen for that?
Amen. Okay.
And you know the difference between being pushed and being shoved and walking leisurely at your own pace, doing what you want to do. Now, the disciples apparently had a little difficulty in the passage this morning. The gospel writer tells two stories. Both have to do with people in need, people in great need. The first about a 12-year-old girl who's dying, and the second about a woman who's been ill for 12 years. Mark begins one story, interrupts with the other story, concludes the first story. It's a technique that's not unusual in the Gospel of Mark. In any case, we're told of a woman who has exhausted all other resources, save one, to come to Jesus. She's met with doctors and shamans and medicine men and tried every medicine, prescription, and otherwise, talked to reputable people and quacks, and nothing. Nothing ever got better.